In this session, we are discussing a very important algorithm, Ford-Fulkerson algorithm for maximum flow problem. Now, what is the maximum flow problem? So, let us discuss the problem at first, then we shall discuss the terminologies and the algorithm as well. See, the problem says that given a graph which represents a flow network where every edge has a capacity. So that means one graph will be given, and that will be weighted digraph, directed graph, and this is the directed graph will be known as the network graph, and this particular network will be known as the flow network, where each and every edge will have one integer value associated, that is the weight of that particular edge or branch, and that will be denoting the capacity of that edge. That means the flow cannot exceed that capacity. Also given two vertices, one is source S and another one is the sink T in the graph. That means the flow will be made originated from source S and will get terminated at sink T. So these are the very important two vertices are there, special type of vertices is in the graph. Find out the maximum possible flow from S to T with following constraints. So this Ford-Fulkerson algorithm is nothing but a method which will calculate the maximum flow through our network. Here the flow can be of anything, the flow can be of anything, and the maximum possible flow from S to T with the following constraints. So while calculating the maximum flow through the network, we are having two constraints. Constraint number one, flow on an edge does not exceed that given capacity. Obviously, the flow through a certain edge should not exceed the respective capacity mentioned as an integer value or numeric value associated with that edge. Inflow is equal to outflow for every vertex except your source and the sink S and T. So obviously, the whatever the flow that will come into a vertex should be equal to the flow out from the vertex. But in case of source, only the flow will come out from the source. In case of sink T, the flow will go into the sink T, it will not come out. So except these two vertices, we're having the flow in and flow out must remain same in all other remaining vertices in this weighted digraph. So while discussing the algorithm, we might be facing different terminologies. So let me go for the terminologies at first. But before going for the terminology, let us see the how does one network looks like. You see, this is a network. So here A is the source, we have written that one, and F is the sink or target. So now from A, only the flow will come out, and to the sink, only the flow will go in. So these are the respective flows we are having. These are the respective flows we are having, and this is a digraph. You are getting this head and tail for each and every edge. So here are the terminologies. So let me discuss the residual graph. It is a graph which indicates additional possible flow. If there is such path from source to sink, then there is a possibility to add flow. That means through a certain path, we can add flow if there is a possibility. Possibility means what? Means the remaining capacity is there and which is non-zero through the path. That means from the source to the sink, all the edges which will be falling on the path, they should be having some residual capacity. So let me discuss the residual capacity at first. So residual capacity, it is the original capacity of the edge minus the flow. Original capacity means these are the original capacities and minus the flow. Okay, so that is known as the residual capacity. Next one is the minimal cut, also known as bottleneck capacity, which decides the maximum possible flow through from source to sink through an augmented path. So I think it will be better if we show that one on this particular diagram, what we are trying to discuss through these terminologies. Okay, now see. Let us consider, we are considering one path, say AC, then D and F. So you are reaching from source to the sink A to F through C and D. Now see, in this particular path, the maximum flow is 11, that means the capacity is 11. Here the capacity is 9, here the capacity is 11. So through this path, the maximum flow can be 9, because it will decide the maximum flow, and that is known as the minimal cut. So here I'm giving a flow with 9, here 9, and here we're having this. So now see, here the residual capacity, here the residual capacity is 2, here the residual capacity is 9 minus 9, that is 0, here the residual capacity is capacity minus current flow through that path, through that edge will be 2. So 2, 0, 2 are the residual capacities for the respective edges. So we have discussed what is the residual capacity, and the graph that's obtained is known as the residual graph. And the minimal cut, I told you this one, that is the minimal cut. So minimal cut means the maximum flow possible through that particular path from the source to the sink is the minimal cut. So in this way it is happening. Now see, as it is having some capacity there, so if we consider the path, say A, C, B, E, and F, if we consider the path like this, so A, C, B, E, and F, here you see, here the residual capacity is 2, here the capacity is 10, here the capacity is 9, here the capacity is 2. So that's why we can have the minimal cut here, that is the bottleneck. So that is also very important, bottleneck capacity, this term is very important. So the bottleneck capacity in this particular path is 2. So what I can do, I can make it 11, so I can make it 2 there, I can make 2 here, I can make 2 here. So here you will be having some residual capacities, but it is quite full. In this way, we shall explain in details in the example. Augmenting path can be done in two ways. So augmenting path can be done in two ways. One is the non-full forward edges, whatever you have done. It is a non-full, it is a non-full. Initially it was 9 and the capacity was 11, so it is non-full. So non-full forward edges, and another one is non-empty backward edges. So non-empty backward edges we shall discuss in one example for the better understanding. So let me discuss the algorithm at first. So Ford-Fulkerson algorithm. The following is a simple idea of the algorithm. We are having three steps. Step number one, start with the initial flow as 0. So initially, I can write here the flow is 0. Initially the flow was 0. Then we made a flow of 9. So flow has become 9. Then we made a flow of 2 here. So the flow has become 11. So in this way, we'll be going for incrementing the flow, because we're going to calculate the maximum flow through the network. So initially we'll be starting with the initial flow as 0. There is an augmenting path from source to sink. Yes, we are getting so many augmenting paths. So here we have demonstrated two of them. Then add this path flow to flow. So this path flow should be added with the flow. So initially it was 0. Then I allowed flow of 9. So it has become 0 plus 9, that is 9. And then I allowed 2 through this. So 9 plus 2, that is 11. So now just add this path flow to the flow value. And in this way, you are going to do until there is no augmenting edge paths are possible from source to target, source to sink. And after doing this, the value of the current flow will be returned. And that is the maximum flow of the network. In this way, the algorithm will work. Please watch the next video where we'll be going for one example for the better and crystal clear conception, to generate the crystal clear conception and better understanding on this particular algorithm. So that video will be in the continuation of this one. Thanks for watching this video.